Hello, I'm Graham and I do hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to today's video. Now today's video I'm going to show you how to modify the dummy battery box, the DCC6, of the FZ80 or 82 camera so it will display the status of your external lithium ion battery pack. Notice here on the bench I've got my FZ82 and it's being powered by this 8.4 volt cycle headlight pack. Now it's being fed into a dummy battery box in the bottom of the unit. And this is the standard DCC6 unit. They're available on eBay for as little as £5 and you can get them on eBay UK and I've seen them on the international sites as well. Now the only problem is when you buy these devices they do not show the status of the external lithium ion battery pack and I can show you that. You see on the back of the camera it's being powered by this external battery pack. But you can notice up above the focus indicator, there should be the battery indicator status icon, and it isn't there. So when we modify this battery box, that icon will appear on screen, and it will give you the status of the charge in the lithium-ion battery. So let's start by showing you how to modify that battery box, the components you need, and the time it will take you to do it. Now the first process is to actually open up this unit and that's the most difficult part of the procedure. I tend to use a modelling craft knife to enable me to cut down the seam between the softer plastic and the harder mount of this device. Just be careful when you're using the scalpel that you don't slip and obviously cut yourself. Take it easy and start at one of the corners and then try and move the heel of the blade into the joint between the two plastic faces and then just work around until you've got it free. The only thing to be careful of is when you're going down on this side where the cable enters that you don't actually cut into the cable. So I'm going to start in this top right hand corner and it's a case of just putting the scalpel into the edge between the two plastic faces and just trying to just separate that. So just moving the blade of the knife into the corner. You might just hear it crack a little bit. There we are. Now I'm going to move over to the other corner. Again, just moving the heel of the knife into the seam between the two plastic faces. Little side riddle. And now I'm going to come down this face. I'm trying to avoid cutting into the cable, which is entered here at this corner. So I'm just trying to put the tip of the knife into the seam and then take it down to the other corner like so. Now you do the other seam. So just reopen that plastic seam, put the tip of the knife between the two faces and then just take that down to the bottom. When you've reached the bottom, you should be able to just pry the two gently apart. Just need to take this a little bit further to the corner. So, and then the two will separate. And you can see inside now we have the printed circuit board. Just feed yourself a little bit more cable through there so you can actually work on the unit. Now what they do is tend to apply quite a lot of hot glue, or in some instances they are putting super glue on here which bonds that cable to the plastic. And I can see actually here on the unit itself there is both the hot melt glue and super glue underneath. So I'm just going to remove this hot melt glue because I need to remove this circuit board in order to do that modification. So I'm just going to use a craft knife and see if I can separate the two units. That's come away quite easily. And it exposes the area that I need to be working on and get exposure to the terminals here on the printed circuit board. Just orientate this so you can get a better view. Free up a little bit more of this glue. So some units have got this hot melt glue and others don't, the ones that I've already modified anyway. So I'm just trying to remove the hot melt glue to give them more access. So it's this part of the circuit board that we need to gain access to. We're going to fit a resistor between the negative lead, the black lead here, and the T-pad on this strip. So I'll get up my soldering iron and the 10K resistor and I'll show you where to fit this and then assemble the unit. Well, I've got the components that I need to actually install this. I've got a pair of needle nose pliers, I've got a pair of cutters, I've got my soldering iron and I've got some solder. Here's my 10K resistor and it's a 1/8 watt, and if you look at the bands here are brown, black, black, red, which indicate that it's a 10K resistor. And I'm actually going to install it between the T pad and the negative terminal. So what I've done is fold the leads of the resistor so we've got a fold back on itself, and I'm going to install the resistor like so. So we've got the longer leg which will go to the T and then a shorter leg which will go to the negative terminal. So I'm just going to cut these off fairly close to the resistor for the T side and then fairly close to the top of the bend for the negative side. So let me just cut those. Like so. And now I'm going to tin the ends of the resistor just to make sure that they've got a good wetting of solder on the component before we actually install it onto the printed circuit board. Just bring the iron over, just clean the tip, and we'll just flow the ends to ensure we've got a good solder on there. Now I'm going to try and install it. I used to have the helping hand, which is like a desktop device that holds circuit boards so you can work on them easily, but I couldn't locate it. So I'm working a little bit back to front here and it's a bit difficult, but I'm going to attach the resistor to the T-pad on the device. The resistor must point up because the contacts are down, so we must install the resistor this way around. So we'll just solder that to the T-pad, and now we're going to bring this lead over and we're going to solder that to the negative terminal, which will be there. Just going to remove this clamp, it's not effectively doing anything. I thought I might have been able to hold it on the table, but it's not actually doing anything, so we just need to bring this lead over. Reposition the camera a little bit, and I'm going to solder the other end of the resistor here to the negative lead. So let me just clean the iron, just apply a bit more solder to tin it. I'm just going to flow that to the T terminal, to the negative terminal, making sure we don't lose the negative connection. So that's the installation. You can see now we've got the resistor connected between the T pad and the negative terminal. All we have to do now is to reinstall this back into the case, apply a bit of super glue to bond the two halves together. So that's the process complete. All you have to do now is to reassemble the circuit board into the base of the case, like so. And then we can apply the upper half of the module and then just run a little bit of super glue around the outside edges to seal it back in place. Just work the cable back out to the outside edge. Make sure it will install. Like so. once you've got a neat seam, you can just apply a bit of super glue to the seam and it will then capillary action and run up the seams and seal it for you. I'll install the dummy battery box into the camera now just to prove that it's working before we actually seal it up. So again, just sliding this inside the battery compartment. Make sure that you pull down the little plastic tab at the side so you can get access to it. Lock the battery in place, turn on the camera, switch over to live view. So you can see now we're running on the external battery pack with that modified DCC6 coupler, and you can see on the LCD screen that we are showing 50%. You can see on the LCD screen here we're now showing 50% indication of power remaining in that lithium ion battery pack. So all that remains to do now is to go around with a little bit of super glue. Just apply a little bit to the seams and let it spread by capillary action and let it set for a few minutes, and then you're ready to go with your modified DCC6 battery coupler. Well, that's it for the video. I hope you found that useful. There will be a full write-up, of course, on my photographic blog with instructions again of how to do it. So if you want to follow along with that, you'll find it in the electronics for photographers page of my photographic blog, and I'll put a link to that in the video description below. So as usual, thanks very much for watching. And if you are a new viewer, please do click that subscribe button and the bell notification icon. And of course, if you do like the video and you think your friends will like it, don't forget to like and share it. Okay, until the next video, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.